By name, I'm Samuel Rutich from Bomet, a relative to the family. And we are so heavy in our hearts that we have lost a very young soul who has just completed the university and was doing his teaching at the Malindi Girls. We learned of the boy through social media, and as relatives we are so saddened, and we are appealing to the authorities, especially the security, to beef up, especially around the school and also around River Yala. So I have nothing much to say because we are saddened and heavy in our hearts. It's only that we are happy again about the human rights that are following the case together with the CID and the Kenya Police. So we are just appealing for the justice. Otherwise, thank you. Thank you. The boy was reported missing on 10th August this year and was found on 27th August, the same this year again.
My name is Joshua Otieno Duor. I work with the human rights organization known as Haki Kwetu. This is the organization that made the announcement of the dumped body which was retrieved from River Yala some few days ago. And as you know that we are happy that today the family is here, the colleagues that the Marehem was with them at school, together they are here today to confirm that the body is theirs, and again they are picking their body for the burial. And we are here at Siaya County Referral Mortuary, and I want to also to thank the media, because through them this message has reached the family and the colleagues. Secondly, post-mortem has been done today, and it has been found that it seemed that the guy was adopted and also murdered before he was dumped at River Yala. So my message to the government, more so to the county, the security agencies in Siaya County, we are saying that a time has come that they should come out and make sure that the security of the people around Yala, and more so to come out very clearly to tell us what is happening here and there again, because we are seeing many of the bodies which are being found in River Yala. They are coming from outside Siaya County. So we are wondering. And again, as a human rights defender, we are also urging the government to make sure that if there is such incidents like the one that we are now talking about, the body must be found and the family be known. Like now, as we speak, we have a body at Yala which is yet to find the family.
My name is Mr. Chumba, a colleague to the late Kipkuru Ngetich. We worked together for close to 4 years now, and at the time of his disappearance, the only clue given is he was dressed in black pants, black top, and he made to the compound where he was residing. But unfortunately, the discovery made in the morning is that he didn't make into his house. What was discovered was his bag, which he carried along from home, and his phone and wallet found at a separate place in the same compound. So this suggests probably that this person who left involuntarily. After that, we made an effort to inquire, and somewhere down the line, we even did put the posters online seeking for any help if anyone could be knowing his whereabouts. And one time, there's something that floated on TikTok, and there was somebody being retrieved. Being in conversation, in contact with my colleagues, and did ask them if they can rush and get to view the bodies, if they belong to the missing person. The team which came, around three teachers and a friend to the school, positively did mention that the results were positive. They belong to the missing person in question. The dad came the following day, as he was still in talks and seeing how to inform them. Somehow he was on his way as well, met to the police station, and he was referred to this place, and the outcome also read positive. So today is a sad day. we've come to pick the remains of our friend and our colleague, a staff mate, and we are laying him to rest tomorrow. As far as the outcome of the postmortem, which has just been conducted, the preliminary thing is that this guy did not drown. This is not a voluntary caused death. This is somebody who was killed elsewhere and dumped at the River Yala, probably after the body is already decomposed or something like that. That is why it was picked in bad shape. Well, as far as the killers, I don't know. We are praying for you people that you don't cause harm to other people. As far as my friend is concerned, I know he's rested. Wherever he's peaceful, he's like this. He's rested. And I hope to see him when eternity comes. Thank you. I think it's not a good picture to the government if we still have such disappearance. And any time, if it is not the government, then the government, I believe, has long arm to reach to who could be these perpetrators. And I know they'll be nabbed. It won't take long. I'm certain they'll be found.
And that is not the
Siaya.
We have so many of them.
Siaya wata wambia ukweli. Wao ndio wali nyonga huko.
I'm going to go to the hospital. Ni jamaa, ni mwanaume, unaona kitu kwa nini? Mwanaume. Sema ashefegi kwanza.